When you market, you're going to, of course, create expectations. And you've got to meet or exceed those expectations. And then by doing that in the final analysis, you build confidence. And those are the steps. But I want you to also understand that these steps are really occurring in an environment that is very challenging. Because the health service is judged not by what you do, but by what you do not do, and people perceive that you do not do. That's how you judge. So you could talk about how many people come in and all that kind of thing. As the evidence available will show, it's one mistake. And therefore, each of us involved in the process has to understand that in an environment where you are judged by what you do wrong, your objective has to be to do it the right way every single time. I'm sorry, that's it. In the healthcare service, you have got to have as your primary objective doing it right every single time, because you are going to be judged by the time you do it wrong. That's the reality. And we've got to understand that the environment has become more charged. People have become more focused. People are now becoming more aggressive. People, in fact, especially people in pain, are lashing out. Justifiably or not justifiably, the reality is that people are lashing out. And therefore, we in the healthcare service have got to understand that in this environment, the responsibility is ours, or the responsibility that on us is even greater for us to deliver at the highest level. I'm saying, therefore, that we don't want a situation where in this facility we have challenges in relationship to attitude. We don't want a situation where we have challenges in relationship to supplies. We don't want a situation where we have problems about people coming to this facility and us not meeting the expectations. And I'm saying, and I want to say this very carefully, the mindset of those who make decisions within the healthcare services is not to find reasons why things could not be done. There'll always be excellent reasons why things cannot be done. And you can find 100 of them. I just want you to find the one way by which it can be done. Because I want to suggest to you that it is not all doom and gloom within the health sector. I've said it in Roxburgh, and I'll say it again, and I'll say it on every platform. I am convinced, and I say so with all sincerity, that the vast majority of persons involved in the health sector in Tobago, and most likely in Trinidad and Tobago, are individuals who are committed, who are caring, who are professional, and deserve our respect rather than our ridicule. I'm saying that without fear of contradiction. And I want maybe to share with you, it's anecdotal, but I think it's important, a letter that was sent to the secretary, the assistant secretary, from a gentleman who went to a hospital, to the health center at Charlottesville. I just want to read a couple pieces of it, because you get so much advertisement of the negative that sometimes you got to see the other side. And the gentleman writes, "I had an experience at the temporary quarters of the Charlottesville Health Center, their community center, last Tuesday, and I've decided that I should attempt to have passed on congratulations and kudos to all concerned." And I want you to bear in mind, it is not a magnificent facility. It is the Charlottesville Community Center in which this is taking place. And the man goes on, "I arrived at 9:30, that's for a treatment, and I was walking out the door 1 hour later." And then he said, "The thing was one of gentle concern and caring for the mainly quite elderly who had come to consult with the doctor. He said he was 59 last December, and he think his age lowered the average age of the people in the center. The systems were efficient. My personal information was taken. I had basic tests done, blood pressure and diabetic testing. And listen to this, in brackets, all using the most modern digital equipment I had ever experienced in Tobago, in Charlottesville. And the doctor who attended to me immediately recognized the issue, assured me that he had dealt with it before, and having had my interview, sent me where he vigorously and competently attacked the problem and treated it. And he ends by, when that ends, he also indicates maybe things work well more often in Tobago than in Trinidad. And he says in bracket, I rather suspect so actually. But I'm so impressed that I've said to my wife that in spite of the remoteness of Charlottesville, I think in my older years, I will come and enjoy that kind of medical attention and support at my other residence. And I want us to give the health sector in Tobago a round of applause. Because there is good news, and there are good people within the health sector. And I'm saying, therefore, that what we are doing in the Tobago House of Assembly is attempt to marry magnificent facilities with persons who have a magnificent attitude. I am not going to bury my head in the sand and not say that we do not have challenges. I am not going to bury my head in the sand and not say that there are things that maybe we could have done better and things that we will have to do better. I'm not going to bury my head in the sand and know that somewhere down the road there are going to be people who are going to be concerned about the health sector and that some of those concerns are going to be genuine and justified. But what I know is that the people involved in the health sector have a commitment to improve it. And I want to just piggyback on a point made by one of the early speakers, that we have to communicate. We have to communicate with one another rather than at one another. Too many times in the health sector, people have concerns and feel the way to treat with those concerns is to talk around the person who is creating the problem and most likely the person who has the solution. I am saying I have no problem in who you talk to, but I think there has to be some process by which there is a dialogue between our clients and ourselves where the clients can inform us, they can criticize us, they can advise us, and most importantly, make recommendations for us to improve. And I'm hoping that a clinic like this, where by definition you tend to have a more relaxed atmosphere, I am hoping that the kind of attitude of the workers, especially those who come directly into contact with the population, would allow us to nurture an environment in which there can be conversation. I don't know about you, but I know when I was a young man, there were three people I didn't like to go and see. Doctor, lawyer, and bank manager. Because most time I go into them from a point of weakness. And they used to treat me as if I come there with a from a point of view. They're not telling me the truth. They're getting on as if I don't have any sense. And they're only telling me what they feel I want to know. Fortunately for us, that attitude has changed, and the majority of doctors now are much more forthcoming. But I'm saying that we have got to recognize that when people come to a center like this, when people come into the medical facility, they come in from a position of weakness. And therefore, you're going to find that in many cases, they will overreact. And some of them are going to be a little bit belligerent because they're frightened. Some of them will send all kinds of negative signals, and I'm saying that I expect that our Tobago Regional Health Authority will spend a lot of time dealing with attitudinal matters and the kind of response between Tobagonians of the professional status and Tobagonians, of course, who make up the rest of the population. So as I conclude, brothers and sisters, because I don't intend to get into all the details about which I know little, I want to just indicate to you that yes, we must celebrate. We must celebrate the fact that under this administration, we are adding to the capacity to deliver. We are adding to our capacity to deliver by providing the infrastructure. And very shortly, despite the challenges there, we will go up to Charlottesville and continue the delivery process. And very shortly after that, we will go on to the Scarborough Hospital to deliver there. But I want to just caution Tobagonians, because you know sometimes if you don't say it up front, people feel it's an excuse you're making. I want to caution Tobagonians about the Scarborough General Hospital, that there must be a lead time between when the hospital is completed, the physical infrastructure, and when services start. The people will tell you, Mr. Cadet will tell you, and that is why you had to have a commissioning process involved in this exercise. And I therefore want to take this opportunity to tell the people of Tobago that when the hospital structure is finished, and the hospital looks like it's ready to take its first patient, it's going to take some time before it takes its first patient. Because as one of the doctors said, it's like moving house. Your house finished, but you have to move in, you have to make changes, you have to do check-in and so on and so forth. So I just want the people of Tobago to be patient in relationship to the hospital, recognizing that as we have delivered at Roxborough, as we delivered at Patients Hill recently, as we're delivering here today, as we're going to deliver in Charlotteville within a couple months, hopefully, we are going to deliver the Scarborough General Hospital, not just a building, but in fact a magnificent facility that is going to provide magnificent service to the people of Tobago. It is in that context, therefore, that I again want to reiterate my congratulations to all those individuals and organizations and units who were involved in this process. And if I did not, did I recognize you, Mr. Frederick? You did, I did. Well, because I find you wasn't smiling, so I told you. But let me just say how very happy I am to be part of this process. And I want to give you the commitment on behalf of the Secretary of Health and Social Services, who I again want to commend for leading this process, and of course ably assisted by his Assistant Secretary, Mr. Cadet. And I also want to pay tribute to the Secretary of the Division of Infrastructure and Public Utilities, who would have come to the rescue of this project on very many occasions. Give Mr. Adams a hand, please. So this is a good day. It is a good day that can get better if we deliver at the level to which people expect. It is a good day that can become embarrassing if we do not do so. And therefore, I am saying that it is an opportunity and it is also a challenge. And therefore, it is with the confidence that we'll ensure that the challenges are surmounted and that the opportunities are maximized that I wish you a very good day and expect that this facility will deliver to the people of Tobago at the level that